Hello, how's it going? So, I made an entire video about all of the details of this particular drama that I've been embroiled in recently, but I decided at the end of the day that it was too depressing and too distressing and it would dredge up too much bullshit that I just decided to go for the classic Tim sits outside by a tree talking at the phone video. Ramble. Basically, I suppose some people who in the past have been allies and have been friends, I've experienced a total falling out with in a way which I find personally distressing and saddening and hurtful. But to go over all of the details of it all over again just sucks. You know, it's just sad. It's low energy. I suppose it's just I've been thinking about reflecting on my time on YouTube, as I want to do occasionally, and the kinds of things that I have done and that other people have done in my area on YouTube, just sort of the way we go about things. I guess for a year or so, as I was getting more viewership, coming from the social justice sphere, pro-feminism, progressive kind of area, you just receive every possible insult that you could possibly imagine. You read through the comments, it's just like, you disingenuous fucking lying twat. You're a fucking piece of shit, virtue signaling, dishonest, out of context fucking liar. You're a sniper. You're a fucking piece of crap. You fucking subhuman loser. I hope you fucking stab yourself in the head. I hope you hang yourself. I hope you get fucking raped. On and on and on. For my first year or so, it was like, it's hard not to take stuff kind of personally, not like personally in the sense that this is a person who is saying something that's real true and genuine, but just in the way that you react to being incessantly insulted and degraded by people in the comment section. You know, you kind of take it like, I feel bad, this kind of sucks, like I wish people weren't saying all of this shit. I'm just trying to be genuine and say what I really believe, so that's kind of sad. But after a while, you start to develop a kind of thickness of your skin and you stop feeling so sensitive or personally attacked by people's comments, and you start to see them more is just some stupid tribalistic crap. Eventually, none of that affected me anymore. I don't care about what shitlords have to say. I don't care about their stupid insults. And somebody who's been following me for a long time says, I think you're kind of full of shit on this, or disappointed in the way you behaved here. I do take that a lot more personally than, oh, I came here from Wank Spanner Douchebag Edgelord's channel to just get butthurt and offended about the fact that you criticized my idol, or that I'm just here to emptily insult you because I got nothing better to do. But eventually I had a falling out with a crew of people who I was involved with, not with everybody, just with one or two of them, but that was enough to have me, I suppose, be more on my own, not have so much of a community, and I felt bad about that. I felt, yeah, I mean, I didn't go about things the perfect way. I could have done things better. I absolutely think that. One of these individuals keeps saying that I betrayed the group and I betrayed everybody by talking about this Facebook group that we had that had been deleted. However, the thing that really stands out to me about that is this particular individual is the only person who cares about that anymore. At the time, maybe like two other people were like, hey, maybe you shouldn't have talked about this Facebook group or whatever, but no one else said anything because I don't think that they cared that I mentioned it. And today, literally, like, no one except this one person cares at all about this. So the impact of me mentioning that we had a Facebook group was nothing. I didn't see any anti-SJWs pick it up. None of them seemed to care. Maybe they could have come up with some conspiracy theories or something about this group that we were in, which was literally just us chatting about things because we relate about stuff because we agree on issues and we have similar beliefs and ideas, but none of them did that. Nobody came up with anything. And I have talked about things before where I was just being honest or speaking my mind and I perhaps shouldn't have, where that has resulted in a negative outcome and me thinking, ah, shit, I really fucked up. I should not have talked about that. I shouldn't have revealed a particular thing because people can use that against you. And I've deeply regretted those situations and thought, God, I wish I just hadn't said something. But this was not one of those cases because nothing came from it. Nothing happened. In fact, the only thing that came about from me talking about that was being hated forever by this particular individual who now sees me as a total scumbag in every possible way and thinks I'm the worst person in the world. Then that is the regret that I have about the situation, is that it's resulted in this long-standing grudge, which is very depressing for me. Because leading on from what I was talking about originally about not giving a fuck about shitlorders' comments, it's a totally different story for me when it's people who I respected and was friends with and whose content I still like and in ways I still respect because I appreciate what they do, and we have kind of similar opinions and similar views, and I actually still kind of like them, even though they hate me. And that's always a difficult situation to be in, you know, liking somebody who despises you. People like that, who I've had a relationship with in the past, treating me in the way that shitlords do, acting like I'm a total subhuman scumbag, an absolute most disingenuous, dishonest, horrible, virtue-signaling, moralizing, loser piece of shit in the world, that actually really fucking hurts me. And it gets to me. I'm human. You know, if you prick me, will I not bleed? I'm sure there's other sayings in that. If you stab me, will I not die? Falling out with people is painful. And it is not an easy thing like some dickhead insulting you who you don't care about because you never respected them anyways. Like when major YouTubers who I don't respect and never liked insult me, I don't care. Because they're fucking wankers. But when people who I guess I wish things had gone better with treat me like I'm a subhuman garbage scumbag, yeah, that hurts. I don't want to play the depression card, but I do suffer from depression, and sometimes if stuff hurts me, I do go into a little bit of a spiral. And I guess over the past few days I've just been trying to get out of that mentality, out of that doom and gloom sense of like, everything is just fucked now, and feeling alone and feeling that everything is just so negative now, and that there's something, you know, flawed with me and wrong with me, because I feel the need to sort of say what's on my mind about things when it's a bad idea, when you shouldn't. You should just not say anything because it just leads to misery for you. I've wanted to make YouTube more of a positive thing, more of an experience of self-expression. And I think I should have some ideas coming up in the future which are all about that. But it's kind of, you just get sucked back down into this fucking muck. And sometimes it feels very dark and very oppressing. And it's hard. And it's hard to kind of see the way out of some things. I don't want to start fucking crying in my own YouTube video. I'm not gonna set that precedent. But it is like, I see the way that some people use YouTube much more for a way of self-expression and exploring ideas. And then I see this whole other part of YouTube, which is just being stuck in a giant whirlpool of diarrhea that you're trying to get out of, but it just gets into your nose and mouth and ears, and you start choking. All you can do is just go with the stream of turds, because that's kind of just what happens. You're just stuck in it. And I've not managed to find that balance. And I guess I'm just continually struggling to figure out what the fuck to do with myself. Anyways, I guess I just want to feel happy, and I want to feel like I'm doing the right thing, and I want to do the right things, but it's very hard to feel that way sometimes. Just feels like you're going backwards. Anywho, I just wanted to wrap up this video by talking about one thing in the previous half-hour video that I'm not going to release because it's just too much shite, which is the idea of associations. People often talk about associations. If I associate with someone who's problematic, what does that mean about me? And if other people associate with people who are problematic, what does that say about them? And what can I say about them, given that I have also associated with problematic people? Basically, with everything, there is a quality to what you are doing. And it's not the thing that you do, it's the quality to that thing. Not counting, you know, crimes and extreme examples. My personal standard for it is, you can associate with anybody. It doesn't matter who it is. You could associate with David Duke, for all I fucking care. You could associate with Hitler. You could associate with goddamn pedophile. I don't care who the fuck anybody associates with. That is not the point. David Schramm, which is a dude I know, he associated with Richard Spencer when he joined to hang out with him and they had a conversation. But the thing that stood out about that conversation was David challenged Richard Spencer the entire time, and he came out the other end basically making Richard Spencer's arguments look kind of weak. And he dominated that conversation, and he didn't have to be rude and he didn't have to be an asshole, but he put up a very robust presentation against a really fucked up Nazi style individual like Richard Spencer. And my reaction to that was, great work, David. It wasn't, oh my god, I can't believe you would go on a stream and talk to Richard Spencer and you weren't telling him to go fuck himself constantly, and you weren't screaming, you weren't yelling, and you didn't rage quit. How dare you, David? No, it was like, sweet. And you did a fantastic job. Good job. So it's not the association itself. that wouldn't make any sense to me. David could have gone on there and said, oh, hey, Richard Spencer, you know, I just want to get to know you. Let's have a nice conversation. Let's relate about some other stuff. Could be a little bit interesting, you know, mix it up. Progressive left winger going on with Richard Spencer and just having a bit of a hangout. Then I would have said, what the fuck? What are you doing? Don't you know who Richard Spencer is? He's like the foremost advocate of the alt-right and white ethnostate and scientific racism and all these different things. Basically a fascist propagandist, and you're going on with him and you're just, oh, it's la-di-da, it's nice to chat to you, Richard. Yeah, I would fucking judge David for that, but that's not what he did. So it's the quality of what you do. And I also believe in forgiveness. I think that if someone in the past has done something to you, that's real fucked up. It could be incredibly fucked up, but they apologize to you. You could say, all right, look, they've said sorry and that situation is over now. So we're hanging out, we're just having a good time. And I wouldn't judge that, like, that's fine. But what I would be against would be not presenting that context anywhere in public so people could actually see that. You know, if you just do that in private, then people see that and they're like, wow, you don't care about this horrific thing that this person said or did. And then you come back, oh, they apologized to me personally or something. Well, people couldn't fucking see that on the conversation you had. I feel like you should bring that up so people could actually see you addressing it, so they can tell like something has changed here and see how it has changed, instead of just people being ambushed by like, oh, suddenly this horrifically scumbag person is all good. A train is coming, it's loud. It's nuanced. As with everything, there are different aspects to it and it changes over time, and I'm never going to judge anybody for growing, or for the people that they're in conflict with also growing and then coming to some kind of new understanding. But I am gonna judge just doing a fucking 180 all of a sudden without any context provided, and then acting like people who are annoyed about that or confused or criticizing that are just the scum of the earth and the worst possible people, that they're moralizing pricks. And on this idea of moralizing and virtue signaling, philosophically speaking, I don't know why there's any reason to care about fucking anything, to be perfectly honest. I mean, I guess just human suffering, isn't it? That's the main thing to care about. But I also have a misguided belief that you should try to do the best you can in any given situation and then try to improve as you go from there. And then if people think that you could do a little bit better, take that on board and actually listen to what they're saying and be like, all right, I'll think about that. You know, maybe we could just forget worrying about the shittiness of stuff people do or say. Maybe that's just the way to go about it. When people say fucked up stuff, just say, I'm not a moralizer, I'm not gonna virtue signal. Go ahead. Do and say the shitty stuff, I'll come chill out with you, and then if anyone complains about it, I'll say, stop being a fucking virtue signaler. Maybe that's the way I should conduct myself from now on. And I guess if that's the case, like, goodbye to all the people who have believed in me so far, or think that I have any particular values. Maybe you should stop being such a bunch of fucking virtue signalers. I'm just about the memes, guys. I'm about the edging out. I don't give a fuck about anyone else. Let's just take it to a very sociopathic Logan Paulish place, okay? Demotivator fans, you're a bunch of fucking cucks. Stop moralizing, stop following a moralizer and a virtue signaler such as Tim, you fucking losers. So from this total drama whore who's just all about the drama for profit and views because I'm a disingenuous fucking lying scumbag who's a piece of trash. Have a good day.